that have alcohol in them? And can we use soaps that have been derived from animal fats and other things of that nature? Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ba'd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that khamr, intoxicants, are najis. Fajtanibuh, be distant from it. And the key word is khamr, not alcohol. Now we do know from a scientific process that alcohol is one of the things that gives this inhibition inebriates the mind, which is the word khamr, yukhamirul aql. It wipes away your mind, it covers your mind. The essence, of course, is the alcohol that's found in perfumes is not alcohol that is an intoxicating one. It's something that's poisonous if you consume it in large amounts. And you will find two opinions amongst the ulama. The majority of opinion is, of course, that the alcohol in and of itself is not seen as an impure substance. And there is a minority opinion that it's something that can be seen as an impure substance in and of itself. I tend to believe that, alcohol is not an impure substance in and of itself. In fact, it can be used as a cleaning agent. It's something that's used as medical swipes and things of that nature. That type of alcohol, subset of it is different to the alcohol that comes out of the fermentation processes. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam. Also with soaps, there are things that may be derived from the animal fats in a particular way. If you want to be extra cautious, inshallah, make sure that they are from ethical means and that they are of a vegetable-based background. Personally, with the change of the structures and the chemical processes, it is no longer an animal byproduct. It's something that's entirely different as to where it is initiated from. And many of the ulama, they refer to it as a part of istihlak. It's been used up in its normal process to becoming an entirely new product. So the ruling is on the new product, not on where it was derived from. And the majority would say that it is seen as permissible. Wallahu ta'ala.